Yo, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Let's talk about the controversy surrounding Black Ops Cold War. Now that the game has officially released today, people are a little bit upset that there's only 8 multiplayer maps available for 6v6, a couple of maps for Fireteam, and of course, a couple of bigger maps that are found in the Combined Arms playlist. Now, the thing that's really rubbing people the wrong way is one of those maps, Cartel, is also available in 6v6. And then we have the two larger maps, Armada and Crossroads. They've actually been toned down to smaller maps for 6v6 multiplayer. And I will say this. I think that Crossroads is a really fun 6v6 multiplayer map. I like small maps like that, and the way that they have it feels very, very good, especially when you play modes like Domination. Keep in mind, at this point, we're talking specifically about multiplayer. If we talk about the bigger picture, yes, zombies released. Yes, we got a campaign that we're able to play, and both are very fun, by the way. But when we look at multiplayer, compared to what it was during the beta, there's really not that much more, and this is what's really aggravating a lot of people. I've had many asking if I can give my personal opinion on this, and I'd love to. I'm gonna do that right now, so hopefully you guys enjoy the commentary. If you don't agree with me, then of course let me know in the comment section below. But this is just what I think happened, and I don't know if it's, you know, I'm not trying to make excuses for anybody, but I think it's just the facts that we need to look at. The world is a little bit different right now. The team at Treyarch was dealt a very strange hand to begin with when this game's development was handed to them, and they had basically a year and a half to scramble and get things together. The second thing we need to look at is how the virus is affecting everyone's ability to work at the studio. We're talking about hundreds, if not thousands, of developers from all of these studios that are working on the Call of Duty franchise taking their battle stations home in order to continue working on this game. Obviously, Activision has their deadlines and they don't want to miss those deadlines, so working from home was the next best option, and I think that this is going to be what happens in the future. Now, like I said, I'm not trying to make any excuses. That's just the facts. We're looking at something that has never happened before that is currently happening in the year of 2020. Even with what's happening in the year of 2020, even with the work from home order that occurred during this game's development, I really feel like 8 multiplayer maps, it's too little. I think at least there should have been 10. Really, in my mind, at least there should have been 12. I definitely feel like this was a situation where they got dealt a bad hand by taking over this game's development and then getting that double whammy of the virus and obviously the work from home orders. That's never good. But I feel in this case, there could have been a pivot when it comes to the maps. Like, think about it this way. They already had 8 new maps. We don't have any remake maps in this game yet. I would imagine that those remakes are going to be coming through with the seasons, which we'll talk about in just a moment. But I don't think there was anything actually stopping the team at Treyarch from reaching back into their big bag of tricks and finding some really awesome throwback maps from the Black Ops series. Now, it would have been a little strange if they put a BO2 or a BO3 or a BO4 map into this game that takes place in between BO1 and BO2, but let's just say, for shits and giggles, they ended up putting a map from BO2 in there, which takes place in the future, 2025. The map is Drone. What would Drone have looked like in 1980? Would that facility have even existed? Would that have been there? Would there have been something else? The point I'm trying to make is, and I'm not a level designer, I don't know how long it takes to do something like this. I don't know if reimagining a map is something that's a humongous process that takes tons and tons of time. But in my eyes, I was thinking, if you take a map that already exists, aren't the bones already there? You know, aren't the structures and everything that exists already there? It's about like retexturing things and adding new material, right? I don't know how much of a process it is to remaster or reimagine anything, but the other map I was thinking of that would actually work very well in this game is a DLC map that came out during BO3 called Splash. Since we know swimming exists in this game and you can do it, that map would actually be pretty dang cool to see reimagined for the 80s. How would that park look? Would some rides still exist? Would it look run down? Would it be broken? Mechanical things need updated? Maybe Perseus is stashing a nuke or some type of material at this abandoned park since nobody goes there to visit it. It's just been taken over by the time, and there might be some nasty rainwater sitting in one of the pools, and you might see a bunch of overgrowth. That's how I'm reimagining Splash. then comes along a huge investor and they buy it and they pretty it up, and then we got BO3 super far in the future, right? But this is like way, way back in the past. And amusement parks can last decades upon decades, so it's totally plausible for something like this to happen. Is it something that they would ever do? I don't know. But in my mind, that's how I was thinking, and that's what I thought they would have done just in case they got to an area where they didn't have enough multiplayer maps. Now, I don't know if you guys remember, but when Modern Warfare released last year in 2019, there was a very similar conversation happening that we're having right now. That game launched with, I think it was 10 launch maps for 6v6. The other maps, people didn't really care for much because they'd rather have like the regular 6v6. Gunfight, I think, had 7 maps, and there were 3 ground war maps that launched in the beginning. So there was a pretty decent amount of content, but many people just focus on 6v6 because that's all they care about. So that's why this is a conversation very prevalent right now in the Call of Duty community. I think what we're looking at is just the future. I don't think that they plan on putting a huge abundance of maps at launch in the game to begin with. I believe Treyarch has actually confirmed that throughout the seasons, they're going to be adding new perks. I think they're going to be adding new field upgrades. I think they're going to be adding new equipment potentially. So there's a chance for them to add a bunch of new stuff as time goes on. And I'm sure that it's going to be great, just like when they add new weapons to the game. But I believe this is the future. If we're really going to look at it this way, and you know, people are really upset about the 8 maps that we have at launch, think about where Modern Warfare started. And think about where it's at now. Pretty much that same thing is going to happen with Black Ops Cold War. When we talk about a game as a service, it starts with very little content and it kind of gets huge by the end. The crazy thing is, I'd much rather have it this way, specifically because, one, it keeps our community together. Everyone gets the maps and the weapons and any game-changing thing, everyone gets that for free. And two, I've never actually played a Call of Duty game all the way through the year plus into the next Call of Duty game. If the rumors of a Season 7 are true, and that actually ends up coming out within the next few days when Season 6 ends in Modern Warfare, I definitely plan on popping back into that game to see just exactly what it has in store, and of course covering the content therein for all of you on YouTube. I know that there are plenty of people on Modern Warfare not planning on getting Black Ops Cold War, and that's completely okay. But really, my whole opinion on the situation at hand is, does it suck that there's a serious lack of maps at launch? Absolutely. I think this is the least amount of 6v6 maps we've ever had in the Call of Duty series, maybe? I'm wiping down the cobwebs in my mind. It's probably been over a decade since we've had a Call of Duty game release with the amount of maps Black Ops Cold War has. And like I said, there's no excuses, but if there were ever to be an excuse, Treyarch definitely has it this year when it comes to how they've had to make this game versus when they picked it up. So that's it. That's pretty much my opinion on it. Does it suck? Yes. Am I already getting bored of the same maps over and over again? Absolutely, because they're the same maps we had in the beta. Yeah. A little bit of throwback maps would be nice. Nuketown's on the way, so I'm excited for that. They're probably going to be doing a 24/7 playlist, which should be sweet. And yeah, Season 1's looking to be pretty spicy. That's all I wanted to say in this video today.